Have you ever heard of a biodiversity baseline or thought about how to measure one? It might be simpler than you think. Biodiversity refers to the variety of living organisms and their interactions. A baseline is a documented snapshot in time, providing a starting point for comparison later. A biodiversity baseline allows you to measure change and impact by recording the state of nature and activities which could affect it right now. Think of how marking a child's height against a wall at different ages can allow you to see how much they have grown. Or comparing photographs of a glacier across different decades can reveal changes in size and position. By helping us to understand and remember the current situation clearly, setting a baseline can inform action now and in the future. Universities all over the world are setting biodiversity baselines by recording information about nature and activities on their campuses. There are lots of different ways to go about it, depending on your resources and goals. You could pick one area to record wildlife and plants in, engage students or local residents, identify rare or culturally important species in need of special help, or analyze other processes affecting nature on campus. If you have access to ecologists, they could help design your survey and identify species. But don't worry, you can still set a baseline without them. Here are some inspiring examples.
At the University of Melbourne in Australia, we have mapped all our trees and plants on campus. This allows us to protect what we have, track what has been removed, and know what to plant to maintain diversity. We visualize these changes in online dashboards for our community to see.
At Government Dunga College in Rajasthan, India, we photographed the condition of different areas on campus before undertaking habitat restoration projects. These before and after photos will be crucial in demonstrating the impact of our interventions.
In Finland, at the University of Turku, we gather staff, students and members of the public to record as many species as they could find on campus within 24 hours in an event known as a BioBlitz. We use the iNaturalist app to help identify species and to keep a record which can be accessed by others in the future.
At the University of Oxford in the UK, we conducted research to calculate our global biodiversity footprint. We catalogued food eaten or wasted on campus, use of goods such as IT and lab equipment, and activities including travel. Through this process, we identified our largest negative impacts on nature to help prioritise action.
Whatever scale and focus you choose, setting a biodiversity baseline is a first and crucial step in helping your university have a positive impact on nature. It can help you identify which actions could be most impactful in the future and measure progress toward your goals. Get started today.